Welcome to another Tech Help video brought to you by AccessLearningZone.com. I am your instructor, Richard Rost. In today's video, we're going to talk about short and long text, when to use short text or long text, formerly called memo fields, in Microsoft Access. Brandon from Brattleboro, Vermont, a Silver member, asks, I know in your classes you say to use short text for most fields and long text just for comments. But what are all the differences between the two, and when should I use each? Well, Brandon, if you've got a text field, chances are you're better off using short text for it, unless you're certain it's going to be longer than 255 characters. So anything from names, to addresses, to phone numbers, to pretty much everything I could think of, except comments or notes, should be stored in a short text field. Long text fields have a lot of drawbacks, and they're not very efficient, and I'll show you why in just a minute. There are lots of different data types in Access, and it's important to know which type to use for what kind of data. Currency values, date time values, yes, no values. So knowing the difference between short text and long text can be just as important. Let's start out with how much information you can put in each type. Short text can store from 0 to 255 characters. Usually it's used for small things, first name, last name, address, that kind of thing, phone number. Yes, phone number should be in a text field, not a number field. Only put number field data in when you have something you're going to be doing calculations on. You're never going to be adding two phone numbers together. So that's a text field. Long text can store up to 64K, 64 kilobytes. That's 65535, I think it is. That's a lot of information, 64,000 characters roughly, in the Access interface if you type it in or edit it in a table or form. You can store up to 1 gigabyte of data, that's a lot more, if you do it with programming, if you do it in code. And I don't recommend it, but you can do it. But figure, for all intents and purposes, it's 64K. So it's a good amount of text to type in things like notes for a customer, directions how to get someplace, recipes, things that you're sure are going to be more than 255 characters. But don't plan on storing gigabytes of data, because the maximum size of an Access database file is 2 gigabytes. If you've got more than a few thousand characters, I strongly recommend storing the data in an external file. And that's a whole different lesson. With short text, you can limit the field size. You can say, I want states to be only 2 characters, for example. With long text, you can't do that. Short text field contain plain text only. Long text fields can store rich text with formatting, colors, and so on. So again, for your notes, if you want to add bold or italics or change things like that, you can store that in a long text field. When you add these as fields on a form, a short text will usually come in as a single row text box, whereas long text will come in as a multi-row text box with a scroll bar. Of course, those are just defaults. You can change that. And of course, the enter key behavior, if you press enter in a short text field, it'll go to the next field, whereas enter in a long text field defaults to going to a new line in the text box. And again, those are settings that can be changed at the form level. Long text fields have an often overlooked feature called append only. And I overlook it a lot because I never use it, but you can set a long text field to be append only. So when the user goes to that record, they can only add to the end of the long text field. They can't change what's already in there. Again, I never use it. Usually things like that are for tracking contacts or adding notes, and I would make another record in a related table to store stuff like that. One important thing about short text fields is that you can use them in combo boxes and list boxes. You know, when you drop that list down to pick someone, well, you can't put long text values in combo boxes or list boxes, so that limits them there. Short text fields are much more efficiently stored in the database as far as the size of your database goes. Long text fields, not so much. I recently built a database to test short and long text fields. I added 1 million records of different sizes, and then I checked the file sizes both before and after compacting the database. And as you can see right here, the two that I selected, 1 million records with 255 characters in them, the file size with short text fields turned out to be 273 megs, roughly, and with long text fields, it's 316 megs. So it's a lot larger of a file to store the same information. So use long text fields sparingly, unless you've got really, really large files. If you don't have fields that you're sure are going to be more than 255 characters, try to stick with short text if possible, if you're concerned about file storage. And of course, remember, a big database is a slow database. I've got more on this database that I built to do this analysis in a few minutes. Some problems with long text fields. They can become easily corrupted. Access really isn't a great repository for storing large bits of information like a huge Word document, for example. So if you've got fields with lots and lots and lots of data in them, your database is more likely to be corrupted than if you're using short text fields. That's both from the theory that I've read and from my personal experience. Every time I've had a problem with a database getting corrupted, it's because of a long text field. Your data can easily be truncated. I've had this happen too. I've had situations where people went to edit their data and somehow it got truncated or chopped off. I don't know whether it's a bug in Access going back many, many years or if it's just something that randomly happens, but I've seen it happen at least a dozen times. Database is running perfectly fine. No warning of any kind of error as far as, you know, like needing to repair the database. Just the data that they knew was in there was gone. And it just got, the field just got chopped in half. So again, that's another reason why it's very important to back up your data. I keep this slide on hand for situations like this. And it's not only important to back up nightly so you have yesterday's backup. You should be saving backups going back. Have a backup from the last couple nights. Have a backup from a week ago. Have a backup from a month ago. And then I store a backup for every month going back a year. And then I store every year. So, because I've had customers where, you know, they lost data and didn't realize they lost data 3 months ago. So to just have a couple of nights worth of backup is not enough. You need to be able to version that stuff and go back and say, okay, well, this record was this in September. It's supposed to be that. It's now February. We have to go back to, you know, September's backups. So make sure you store backups and keep versions of them. Related to truncated data, if you've got data that's been imported with code, like I said before, you can have up to a gigabyte of data in that long text field. And if you then go to try and edit it in your form, it's going to truncate it right off at 64K. So again, that's the truncation's a problem. Access doesn't handle really, really large files that bad. Like I said, some notes, some comments, a few, you know, a record of what you talked about, directions how to get somewhere, that's okay. Don't try to store, you know, 800 pages of information in a single memo field. If you try to use aggregate queries with long text fields, those are things where you do like sums and group bys and such, and some other things, some types of SQL, like union queries. If you include a long text field in any of that stuff, again, it will get truncated and sometimes corrupted, and sometimes extra characters get added to it. So again, notes, memos only, that's fine. Don't put anything in a long text field that you're going to have to do any kind of reporting on or relating to something else or group bys or any of that stuff. If it's anything other than notes for you to just sit there and read, you know, human read, not the computer has to analyze, just you, then okay, you can put it in a long text field. If you think you're going to want to be, you know, grouping on it and searching on it and storing it and all kinds of crazy stuff, no, don't do it. Now, as bad as long text fields can be, there have been some improvements, some changes, since they used to be memo fields. Now, again, I learned this stuff back in the 90s. That's when I first started learning Access. So some of those habits and some of those things, you know, stuck with me. So in some of my classes, you might hear me say things like long text fields can't be sorted. Well, then now they can. They've changed that in recent versions of Access. I'm not exactly sure when. Some of this was news to me. You can now search, sort, and filter on a long text field. Again, you shouldn't have to, because that's not the kind of stuff that you should be sorting on. But if you want to do a search through all of your long text fields and look for the word Batman, you know, what if you're storing, like, you know, let's say a brief synopsis of stories that you've read, well, okay, now you can search inside your long text fields. Indexing. Memo fields couldn't be indexed. I was quite surprised to find that long text fields now can be indexed. So again, I can't think of a reason why you'd want to, but you can. Indexing is designed to speed up searches and sorts. So I guess they figured, well, since they can, they did. But again, I can't fathom why you'd want to. As I mentioned in the last slide, Memo fields couldn't be used in aggregate queries before. That's where you take sums and group bys and mins and maxes and stuff. Now you can. Again, why, I don't know, but you can. I did read on one page that I was doing my research on, it said that aggregate queries, searches and filters and stuff will only look at the first 255 characters. I have not personally verified this, but that's what I've read on a couple of different sources. But again, you shouldn't be doing these kinds of things with long text fields anyways, so why bother? Okay, so that's pretty much it. The difference between short text and long text. And again, for most fields, like I stick by my original viewpoint that you should be using short text for most fields except for your random notes. You can put those in long text. If you're going to be collecting a lot of notes on someone and over a, you know, a regular period of time, if you want to store notes whenever you talk to a customer, don't put it all in one long text field. You can, but don't. You should use a second related table to store contact information, and every time you talk to them, make it a separate long text field in a related table. Don't just store all of it in one customer long text field. You will eventually get to the point where that field is unmanageable and very difficult for the database to work with. Plus, if you do a second related table, a contacts table, for example, then you could store the date and time of the contact, how long the call went, all that information in the relevant fields, and then just put the notes in a long text field. Long text fields are, they're good. They have their place. Just don't overuse them and don't rely on them for anything other than simple human read comments and notes. Now, where did I get those efficiency stats from? Well, I built a compact and repair database that did a whole bunch of analyzing for me. And I actually recorded it. It's about 3 hours long, the building of this monster database. And it's a video that's set for members only. That's going to be released very shortly here, if not by the time you watch this. Basically, I built one database to add records to tables. You specify the number of records and then, of course, the length of each record. And it just went and looped. And another database would open the second database, set its parameters, let it run, and then close it, analyze it, compact it, and do all that stuff. So if you want to learn a whole bunch of crazy stuff, it's a 3 hour long video. It covers the sleep function, opening another database, waiting for that database to exit, compacting with VBA, reading and writing text files. We use text files for the settings file, so the one database knows what the other one wants. Reading file sizes, deleting and renaming files, record sets to add the records. 3 hours of insanity because it's just me pulling my hair out wondering why things are happening the way they are. I've always been taught a certain way about, like, the books I've read and the classes I've taken and taught, you know, as, this is how you do it. Well, sometimes I, now that I'm more of the expert, I want to know these things for myself. So I built a database to test the efficiency of short text and long text and test the efficiency of compact and repair. And I've got a whole bunch of interesting information. Next, I'm going to be putting together a free tech help video on compact and repair, which is where this slide came from. But if you're interested in all this crazy stuff, that's for my members, silver members and up. How do you become a member? Well, you click on that join button right under the video and you'll see a list of all the different options for the different levels of support. But, of course, my tech help videos like this one will always be free. I'm going to keep making them as long as you keep watching them. If you like this video, make sure you give it a like and share it. And, of course, hit the subscribe button and click the little bell so that you get notifications whenever I release a new video. If you have not yet checked out my free Access Level 1 lesson, it's 3 hours long and it's absolutely free. It's on my website and on YouTube. And if you like Level 1, Level 2 is just $1 and that also is free for members. Want to have your question answered in a video just like this one? Well, visit my Tech Help page. There's all my other cool stuff. And thanks for watching. I hope you learned something, and we'll see you next time.